the Modi government completes 4 years in office, we take a look at the progress of reforms across sectors. Today, in the first of our week-long series, we focus on the Prime Minister's flagship project for urban transformation, the Smart City Mission. Progress has been admittedly slow, with the Parliamentary Standing Committee report released in March 2018 criticising the scheme for its slow pace of implementation. The panel pointed out that of all the urban missions, the Smart City project has the lowest utilisations of funds at 1.83% of the total 9,943 crores released till that time. Other than the utilization of funds, the project continues to be plagued by several other challenges. Importantly, area-based projects are struggling to take off, and the success stories are limited to three states, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra and Gujarat, where the central and state governments are aligned. In non-BJP ruled states like Tamil Nadu and Kerala, the progress is slow. Joining us now to take that discussion forward are two very special guests, Samir Sharma, the director of the Smart Cities Mission at the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, and NSN Murthy, leader for Smart Cities at PWC. India. Gentlemen, appreciate you joining us here on the show. Mr. Sharma, let me come to you, sir, and let me pick up on that parliamentary panel report. The parliamentary panel report very clearly said the committee fails to understand how the ministry will be able to achieve the targets with less than 50% of the allocation sought by them for the same. So one is what you asked for from the finance ministry and what you were finally allocated in the budget. And the second is the pace of implementation. This was the report that was released in March, and I know that the minister believes that there is some lag between what the parliamentary report put out in public and where things currently stand. So let me ask you to start by giving us a status check of where things currently stand on the ground.
You know, the Smart Cities Mission is not business as usual. Hmm. If you were just doing simple contracting to make roads, it would have happened by now. You know, it's made in a way that it takes time to start because the selection itself is through a competition. Hmm. If a selection was through a normative method of multiplying population, etc., you could have done that in 1 year.
Yeah.
So selection takes 1 or 2 years. Mm. After selection, they make a company. Mm. And after that, they appoint project management consultants.
Yeah.
Once they do that, the work really starts.
Right.
So, you know, it's sort of back-ended. A lot of things cluster at the end.
Sure.
So you start slowly and then you really accelerate exponentially. Mm. So it is structured that way. And
okay.
In fact, we have reached that stage. We could call it the escape velocity,
okay,
where we really start off.
Okay, you're saying that you've reached the escape velocity stage where you will really start off. But what does that mean? Can you share some numbers with us? Which are the states where you're seeing the maximum progress? And when you say you will see a takeoff, what does that mean exactly?
It means, let's see, around 30,000 crore worth tenders have been settled. Mm. Works are in progress. Mm. Another 20,000 crore tenders have been called. Mm. And they'll be settled. So imagine 50,000 crores. And, you know, JNURM, you compare 9 years, 40,000 crores work they had done. Mm. So we have settled around 50,000 crore tenders. Mm. And another 20, 30,000 crores are in the works. So mm. they'll soon come into the market.
Okay.
And if you look at the works which have really progressed, one is this idea of a smart city center, mm. you know, which is an integrated center.
Right.
Then you have the area-based development, which is completely integrated development of the mm. area. You have the smart streets. And then you have the basic infrastructure.
Mm.
You know, a smart city should have water,
yes,
sewerage, drainage.
Of course.
You just cannot have IT
no.
on top of that parks and all
right.
that. That comes on top.
So you know, as I pointed out that our colleagues who have been tracking the smart city progress, you know, their view is that the data and command control centers are the ones that have essentially come up. I mean, these have been, you know, the ones that the government can showcase as having been able to execute on time. But what about the rest of it?
Okay, let's look at the others. The roads, very important.
Mm.
You know, we want to reclaim the streets mm. where the people can walk, that mm. experience of walking on a pedestrian highway, something like Barcelona or Europe.
Yeah.
So look at the road. Let's start from Bhubaneswar. There mm. are three roads.
Mm.
One road they've started work, the Janpath.
Okay.
The other two roads they are going to bid. Look at Ranchi, four major roads they started work. Look at Pune, they finished pilots in two. Mm. Others are in tender. You see, roads take time because
mm.
we are not repairing roads. We are reorganizing roads.
Right.
In the sense, changing the size of the footpaths, giving a place for all the people who have been working there.
Mm.
You know, so it's a complete reorganization of the roads.
Okay.
And that takes time. The designing takes time. And then, you know, the bidding takes time because it's just not giving it to the lowest bid.
Yeah.
You have to do a technical evaluation.
Mm.
So all this takes time. The first time at city level, this is being done.
Mm.
So
I'll come to some of the other specifics, but before I get Mr. Murthy in of PwC, one quick question. You said that you're at the escape velocity point and we're going to see things begin to take off. But what about the other criticism of the parliamentary panel about funds and about the fact that you don't have the requisite funds to be able to ensure that you see escape velocity?
It's not fair for me to talk on the parliamentary, but I'll tell you what they said. They said we had obtained utilization certificates for 1.6%. That doesn't mean expenditure. That means they've spent the money, reported it to us, and asked for more money. But that doesn't mean it's not spent. You know, works happen on ground. Then they've measured. Then the bills have to be made, money paid. So you know, it's a 6 months process.
Okay.
Works on grounds is much more.
Okay.
Yeah.
So work on the ground is much more. Let me check if Mr. Murthy agrees with your data. Mr. Murthy, do you agree with the assessment that we just heard here? And also some of the specific feedback that we're getting. One, you know, on the overlap that exists between the Smart City Mission and the Amrut projects, is that causing issues on the ground, especially when it comes to things like jurisdiction, etc.? Is that something that that you've observed and you would be concerned about? And also, you know, do you believe that, you know, funding is going to be an issue? One of the interesting ideas that we saw take off when it comes to municipal bonds, only Pune has taken that forward. We haven't really seen escape velocity or takeoff for the municipal bonds, for instance. So where do you believe the focus now needs to be?
Okay. So let me start with saying that I think what Dr. Sharma said is bang on the assessment of the smart city in terms of how they're moving. From the progress standpoint, look at break it up into two parts. One is the planning and the second is the implementation. It needs a specific planning. The cities need planning time to actually do that. I think they spend a good amount of time in building the SPV, which is ring fenced from the various debts and the issues of a municipal corporation, and that is now an independent body to do the implementation work. The second is how do you get and aggregate various departments, projects, and do it under that, in this under the SPV and deliver it. That has been our biggest victory in terms of the smart city. The governance has been put into the place, and it's the first biggest milestone which has been achieved in terms of the managing the cities. The second part is where the consultant comes on board and work on the technical proposals and the concessioning and the bid management happens.
Yeah.
It takes time. And thereafter, when the infrastructure companies come in, they will also take time in terms of survey and land management and doing all those activities. So it's fairly robust in terms of going step by step working. So I would say the milestones set by the mission have been achieved at a lot of cities. Few cities will always be at a disadvantage due to various reasons. We always, whether it is the land or the issues of hiring of resources or technical capacities, they will be always a challenge. Those will be the outliers. Coming back to your point on how does the city actually is monetization and the municipal bonds part of it. Now, again, this also depends upon the health and the attractiveness of the city from the beginning itself. It was always, we knew that Vizag, Ahmedabad, Pune will be always way ahead of others in terms of doing some kind of a innovative models in terms of raising finance. But other cities which are actually a step back, they are learning fast and they're also getting into this space. They might not come with the municipal bond, but they will come with the value capture finance, which actually again the ministry has taken out as a separate initiative, and they will do those programs. I think cities are learning from each other, and that's what is the biggest activity which is happening. It's going good on the ground. It might actually be even faster if we have much more support and the rigor given by the state governments. But at the end of the day, you will have a progress which is far more efficient and far more positive than any other schemes.
Okay, so you're saying that one of the positives is the fact that states and cities are learning from each other, which is a great thing because in India we often have this habit of wanting to reinvent the wheel. Mr. Sharma, let me come back to you now and talk about one of the other issues that Mr. Murthy alluded to, and that is the participation and the role of the private sector in all of this. In terms of PPPs, in terms of being able to get you know, the private sector involved as CEOs, I mean, you have largely IS officers who are now running these projects. You tried your hand with trying to retain private sector talent, but that didn't quite happen. So both on the PPP side as well as being able to draw in the private sector to be an integral part of this mission, what's the outlook?
See, what we are finding, the severe shortage of human resources, even in the private sector. Mm. You know, today we are just not able to get street designers. We just have people with general urban planning qualifications. We're just not getting urban designers.
Okay.
It's becoming such a big, because they never envisaged that such a demand would be created. Mm. About CEOs, what's happening? People are coming and going. Chennai, they are coming, they came. So they keep on coming and going. Mm. And
why aren't you being able to retain them?
You know, I would say it takes time to get used to this political economy. Mm. You know.
How much is the political economy weighing on the progress of the mission?
You see, some places it's really accelerating it. Some places it is retarding it. Mm. The political economy is local. Mm. It's city-oriented, little bit state-driven. So it depends.
So which are the best performing states? Which are the worst performing states?
Let's start Andhra Pradesh, Odisha.
Best performing.
Madhya Pradesh.
Okay.
Gujarat. Mm. Karnataka has picked up very much. Mm. Then Tamil Nadu now.
And so it's not just the BJP rules.
No, no, and even north, you know, look at UP. Varanasi is way ahead of others in tendering and, you know, all this stuff. Mm. So even within states, there's a big difference between the cities. It's just not the BJP. Mm. I would say, you know, it's just, I mean, you really can't conclude from this data.
And which are the worst performing?
You know, I really haven't done that.
I put you on a spot. Okay. Mr. Murthy, let me ask you that question now. You know, as we move forward and approach the deadline that the government has set for itself, what do you think will be the 2-3 key priorities that they must focus on to ensure that we meet the timeline?
Couple of things which very quickly come into my mind. One is, how do we actually set up and ensure that the board of the SPV is much more functional and more strategic? Why I'm saying is very simple thing.
Okay.
It's a public limited company. The board needs to play a strategic role. The board now, if it is built right and the right focus is brought into the board, the strategic direction to replicate the projects which have been taken up at the ABD area can be much, much effectively done across the city, because that's what the board can play a larger role than the SPV CEO. So that's one part which needs to be brought. The second is, I completely second the thoughts of Dr. Sharma on the technical capacity at the ground level. Not just the technical capacity from the private sector standpoint, but also the technical capacity at one level lower to the SPV, which is the executive engineer and the engineers who actually get deputed from the municipal corporation, who are actually hand-holding the entire process today on behalf of the staff of SPV. That needs to be now trained, and they need to be actually done a job rotation, and their capacities from a project management and financial management and procurement process needs to be enhanced. So that's the part number two,
okay,
which if it is done, then you'll see a kind of a improvement in the way in which the mission can progress the faster. The last one, which is not the least, I think we had one successful knowledge sharing session in Bhopal this year, this month, 8th and 9th.
Yes, very recently.
We need to actually have that more often. So that, absolutely, we need to have that more often, whether it is virtual, whether it is face-to-face. But I think those have led the cities to talk to each other. And we know a lot of CEOs now, after that workshop, have been started talking to each other, sending mails saying that, can you actually share that copy of the MOU, how you are actually done that bid. Those are the ones which actually are creating, reigniting the collaboration between the cities. And this will fasten up a lot of processes and a lot of projects. And that's I think, the three quick things. I'm looking at a six-month
valid
time
point.
Window in which most of the projects can actually move into the contracting stage.
Into the contracting stage, is that what you agree with, Mr. Sharma? I'll end by asking you, in 6 months, do you see most of these projects moving to the contracting stage?
Yeah.
How much do you hope to get done in this financial year?
By June, we are planning 40,000 crore
June
works.
June this year?
Yes, 40,000 crore works will be in progress. By June next year, 40,000 crore works will be complete.
Okay.
And 100,000 crore works will be in progress by next June.
Okay.
And these 40,000 crore in the next year will be completed, so you can see all the roads, you can see all this stuff happening. And the invisible part, which is the command control center, which really brings about women's safety and a lot of stuff like that. That is going very fast because, you know, it's easily replicable. They did one or two, others replicated. Yeah. But road is like this. A Pahadganj road, a GK road, you cannot you cannot replicate.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, it requires something very uniquely contextual.
Sure.
So that's what.
Okay, so 40,000 crores by June this year, 40,000 crores by June next year. That's the roadmap that's been laid out here by Sameer Sharma for the Smart City Mission. Appreciate you joining us here on CNBC TV 18. Ennison Murthy, thanks very much for your time. That's the first report card on CNBC TV 18 as the Modi government completes 4 years in office. Up next, we take a look at another flagship program, the Make in India campaign. Prime Minister Modi made the announcement from the ramparts of the Red Fort in August of 2014. It was launched in September of 2014 as it lived up to the hype. We discuss that and more when we return.